Evening all. Just spent a few hours today with an angle grinder and wire brush just cleaning up the hopper cylinder casting off the old Lister Junior A type. It's come up quite well, I'm pleased with it. I didn't even have to use paint stripper on it. I mean, the angle grinder just takes it off, rips the paint off, but it doesn't damage the castings. Just cleaned it all up with white spirit. It's come up quite well. Obviously in this cold damp climate that we have here, you can just see a bit of surface rust appearing already, so I'll have to just give it all a dusting over with a wire brush before I paint anything. I've cleaned up the bore as well, decoat the cylinder. That's quite difficult to do with it being a blind head, but you can do it. Just want to make sure there's no loose carbon in there really. So I've done that, and I've honed the bore by hand with some emery paper. Takes a little bit of doing, but if you're careful, you can get a nice neat finish. So it's taking the glaze right off the cylinder, and in the pictures, you should be able to see the sort of cross-hatching. When I took the valves out, I marked where they go, so I actually marked the valve stems with a punch mark, so it's got two punch marks. Now, I've got some new valve guides for it. I got these from Stationary Engine Parts, and I considered making my own, which would have probably been a bit cheaper, but they have to be made from a particular grade of cast iron, because that retains oil. So in the end, I figured what with the time it would take, it was actually just easier to buy some. So I got those as a 19th birthday present, which was quite handy, and gets me out of trouble. Could never have run with the old valve guides, they were just too worn. So yeah, they're a nice fit, and should help the engine run a bit quieter, maybe a bit more compression as well. So I've cleaned out where the guides are going to go, white spirit and a bottle brush, very carefully cleaned that, so they should drift in there nicely. So the next project, I've got a bit of brass bar over here. I'm just going to turn up a little drift punch to just press those in there. There was a core plug in this side, or a little sort of bung, where you could put a water drain tap if you wanted to. On this engine, the drain tap goes on the mag side there. So at some point, the bung that was in this side, someone had attacked it with some vice grips trying to get it out. So first of all, I thought about replacing it and had a go myself at getting it out, but it was well stuck. So I then tried using a file to put four flats back on it, but I just couldn't get it to look anything decent. So got a hacksaw and just cut it off, then used a file to, you know, bring it flush again. I'm quite pleased with that, and once painted, I mean, it shouldn't notice. It's not original, but I'm not too worried about that sort of thing. You know, if I wanted to, I could always drill that out and replace it with another bung. I've also cleaned up the... Well, I haven't washed it with white spirit yet, but the gear side housing. Nice bronze bushing in there, it's in good nick. Cleaned up all the sealing surfaces as well, so that'll be ready to have a gasket cut. Crankcase door, that's been cleaned up, come up quite nice. What else? Oh yeah, new gasket for this cylinder there. Yep, so I'm going to just turn up a quick drift and get those valve guides. Don't worry about the squeak, it's just the belt. Got a metal joiner. Okay, here's my little drift. The reason it's so long is so that it sits right down inside the guide there. The idea being it's less easy for the cast iron to snap then, which is what happened when I tried to get the old ones out. So we'll give it a tap, see what happens. I've cleaned out the hole where the guide goes. Hopefully it'll be all right. Just check they're both home. That's it. That was quite easy really, much easier than getting them out anyway. So the next thing to do, I'm going to turn it over, put the valves in, just check they line up with the seats, and then hopefully grind the valves in. Righto, I'm just about to start grinding in the exhaust valve now. Done the intake valve and the seats come up quite nice. You can see it's come up quite bright. There's no pitting there and the valve's pretty good, so yeah, quite happy with that one. Really nice. I don't quite understand why the intake valve seat has got pitted and the exhaust valve, or rather the head of the valve, whereas the exhaust hasn't, but then it has on that side. Most peculiar. Anyway, so I was using the fine grinding paste for that side. Just cleaned it all up with white spirit and I've put a drop of oil down the guide whilst doing this. So I'm going to move on to the exhaust side now, so I'll film that for you. Okay, so I'm going to have a go at grinding in the exhaust valve now. So I've got a bit of grinding paste here. I'm just going to start with the fine stuff. Once I know how bad or how good the seat actually is under that carbon, then I can, you know, tell if I'm going to need the coarse stuff or not. So let's try that. So just get a drop of oil down that guide and away we go. Don't want to get any on the stem. Okay. Well, at first glance it doesn't look too bad, so we'll give that a little wipe round, have a look at the seat, see what it's come up like. I think I can see a bit of pitting there. Yeah, it's going to need quite a bit of grinding, so we'll keep going on that and see how we get. Right, I've finished valve grinding for now and it's come out okay. The exhaust valve seat's still a bit rough, bit of pitting, but I think it looks worse than it is. The engine was running fine with plenty of compression, so I'm going to leave that for now. I've seen much worse, so it's a lot better than it was. The intake valve seat, on the other hand, is a lot better. Really quite nice. That's the intake valve and the exhaust. But yeah, very pleased with those new guides. They went in there a treat. I think next I'm going to start thinking about what I want to do with the fuel tank. It looks like I may have to drill a couple of holes, drill and tap a couple of holes in the crankcase, because I want to crankcase mount a tank. So before I paint the engine, it makes sense to do that. Now I've got three options: that tank there, which I was using from an old Villiers, an ATCO tank there, which is a little bit bigger and a bit shorter, or I could get made a Lister A style crankcase mounted tank. This being an A16, it would originally have had a trolley mounted tank, so what I'm doing here isn't strictly original, but the later engines, like the A28s on these Witchy fuel bowsers, they had them, so I can get away with it, I think. If I use a round tank, then I've got to make some blocks behind, probably out of that mahogany there, to try and support it. So it may be easier to get you know, a proper A-type style tank made. The reason I've got to do this, obviously, is storage problems. I haven't got enough space, and the gap that I have to get the engine through to get it past the house. So I'm going to think about that and see what I can come up with. Just going to clean that up. And we're also going to replace the exhaust. Going to get a proper A-type style one, because that is a homemade job. So yeah, that's it for today. So I hope you've enjoyed the video, and thanks for watching.